students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding resolving the nuclear liability deadlock. Now this editorial is written by Anupama Sen and Aragya Sen Gupta. From examination point of view, it will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, paper 3, and it would be helpful to the students of political science optional. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand the approach that the India is following with respect to making the international organization liable for the accidents that may take place in the years to come. Now, as far as this editorial is concerned, it focuses on certain players. Now, who are those players? First of all, there is a player who will be supplying the material for setting up the plant. That will be the supplier. Now, the second actor will be the one who will be operating that nuclear plant, operator. Then there will be the government. Then it will involve the people. So this editorial, it involves around these four players: the supplier, the operator, the people, and the government. Now, as far as the liability clause in India is concerned, it has been institutionalized. It has been entrenched in the form of Civil Liability Nuclear Damage Act. Now, what is this act about? This act basically stipulates about how the liability will be paid, who will be liable, and who are the people who can take up a recourse to court to get their rights addressed. Now, this is the approach for the liability that India is focusing upon. India is being overtly cautious. India is being overtly proactive in deepening and widening the clauses with respect to the liability. हम बहुत ज़्यादा focus कर रहे हैं liability के ऊपर. In case कोई accident हो जाएगा, तो वो जो ऑपरेटर है वो पैसा देगा, जिन लोगों का नुकसान होगा कि सप्लायर पैसा देगा, कितना पैसा देगा, एंड कितनी टाइम लिमिट तक ही विल बी हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल. नाउ व्हाई इंडिया इज सो मच ओवरटली कॉशियस एंड प्रोएक्टिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस लायबिलिटी. नाउ वी आर बीइंग वेरी मच प्रोएक्टिव बिकॉज इन द हाइंडसाइट व्हाट वी हैव सीन is the disaster because of Bhopal gas tragedy. Now, that was a tragedy that has left stains on the minds of the people. And the conscience of the governments for the years to come. And it is out of that concern that we want to have a very strict standard. What I'm focusing here is on the word standard. We want to have a very strict and rigid standard with respect to the liability on the operators as well on the suppliers. But why India is having dispute with the United States of America? Now, as far as this entire technology with respect to civil nuclear is concerned, we will be importing the technology from United States of America. And the companies of United States of America, they will be supplying the entire technology. Now, in case some accident will take place in the future because of the faultiness in the design of the plants or of the some substandard services, then the supplier, then the operator can take a recourse in suing the supplier, and the supplier will be bound to compensate the victims from that accident. Junka bhi nuksan hoga, usko paisa dena padega. Now, as far as the civil liability nuclear Damage Act is concerned, it is having two sections underneath it, which are a matter of concern for United States of America. Now, those sections are Section 17B and Section 46. Now, we need to understand both these sections. Now, as far as the Section 17B is concerned, it will make the operator, it will provide a leeway, it will provide a freedom to the operator to sue the supplier in case something will go wrong. But what is the area of concern is the time and the money that by which the supplier will be compensating the people. Kitna paisa wo dega supplier? Aur kitne time tak wo responsibility apne upar lega? This is the area of concern between India and United States of America. This is something that is not letting the relation between India and United States of America to smoothen. Then we have Section 46. Now, what is this Section 46 about? This section is about for what the supplier will be liable. Kis cheez ke liye supplier liable hoga? Civil cases or criminal cases? And what the recourse the people can take against the supplier? Kya jo aam janta hai, jo victim hogi, wo kya supplier ke against case kar sakegi ke nahi kar sakegi? Now again, this is an area of concern. Now this, the way this section has been written in black and white, it is very ambiguous. It is not very clear. Now if we read it in at the prima facie, what feel we get? The feel it gives is that the people individually can file up a case against the supplier. So why there is a lot of hue and cry? The hue and cry is because of the stringent liability provisions that are being put on the supplier. And because of that, the United States America's companies, they are not ready to conduct this nuclear trade with India, nuclear technology trade with India. And why the United States of America had signed up this Indo-US nuclear deal? They had signed up this deal prospecting, visualizing that they will be earning in billions out of the technology and out of the transfer of machinery that they will be doing to India. But what is dissuading them, what is stopping them is the stringent civil liability nuclear damage acts provisions. There is also a lot of hue and cry in the Western countries about this liability bill that India has set in, because the standards that we have set up, they are actually against the treaties and the conventions that are currently enforced in the form of Vienna Convention. Jab un conventions ka standard hai, that is very diluting standard with respect to the standard that the India wants to set up with respect to this liability. India wants to protect the victims, but United States of America, it wants to protect the suppliers. So again, indirectly, it is a fight between capitalism and socialism. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to my channel. Name of my channel is EIES Mentors. You can contact me. Actually, you can contact EIES Mentors at 84594-0000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes from EIESmentors.com. So for the students who have taken up their mains examination, and in case they want the free guidance for this interview, they can mail up their resume, that detailed application form, at brainyki@gmail.com. You can also install EIES Mentors application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find the Brainyki application from Google Play Store and from App Store. This is for the Apple users. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.